serial dilution, and plate count, preparing a standard plate count of viable bacteria. In this section, you will learn how to quantitate bacteria using the serial dilution and plate count method. Bacteria are serially diluted and plated onto agar plates using a septic technique. Labeling test tubes for a 10-fold serial dilution and agar plates for plating. First, label 8 4.5 milliliter broth test tubes from 10-1 to 10-8 and 5 agar plates from 10-5 to 10-9. Once you begin, remember to always work close to the flame. The hot air generated from the flame helps to reduce airborne contaminants. Also remember to change your pipette tips every time you transfer a solution from a higher to a lower concentration, and mix each solution well before starting a new dilution. Performing a 10-fold serial dilution. Before you start, use a vortex mixer to ensure the sample of bacterial culture is mixed well. Apply a septic technique with a micropipette to transfer 0.5 milliliter or 500 microliters of the culture to the test tube labeled 10-1. Mix the test tube well. Then transfer 0.5 milliliter of this solution into the test tube labeled 10-2. Mix this test tube well. This process is repeated until all 8 test tubes are done. Now you have a 10-fold serial dilution of your bacterial sample. Inoculating or plating the agar plates by spreading technique. The next step is to plate or inoculate the agar plates with the dilutions just produced. Apply a septic technique and start with the diluted sample in the test tube labeled 10-4. Transfer 0.1 milliliter or 100 microliters of this solution into the agar plate labeled 10-5. Change the pipette tip and continue to transfer 0.1 milliliter of the diluted samples from 10-5, 10-6, 10-7, and 10-8 test tubes to the agar plates labeled 10-6, 10-7, 10-8, and 10-9, respectively. Apply a septic technique to spread the bacterial diluted aliquot evenly on the entire surface of each of the agar plates just prepared by a sterilized cell spreader. The diluted samples from 10-1 to 10-3 are highly concentrated, which will produce confluent growth on the plates, therefore they should not be used. Incubation of inoculated plates. Incubate the plates with the bottom up in an incubator at 37 degrees Celsius for 18 to 24 hours to allow the bacteria to grow to count colony forming later. Discard all contaminated tools and waste into a biohazardous container and disinfect the bench. The plates can be stored in a 4 degrees Celsius refrigerator after incubating until the next period. Counting bacterial colonies. After incubation, bacterial growth is visible as colonies on the agar plates. To determine the number of bacteria in the original sample, a plate with 30 to 300 colonies is selected. The number of bacteria in the original sample is calculated using the following equation. Colony forming units per millimeter equals the number of colonies on plate divided by the dilution.